Hi everyone, this is Pooja Khandelwal Bhunwe as assistant professor of AIDS of AISSMS IOIT. Now in this session we see the 2D rotations, that is 2D transformation second technique, that is 2D rotation. Now we will go from that rotation. So all of you know the definitions of 2D transformation. So we will see. The 2D transformation is a process of modifying and repositioning the existing graphics. So it will take place in a two-dimensional, that is two, that's why it can say that 2D transformation. So transformations are helpful in changing the position, size, orientation, shape, etc. related to the object. So there is a different techniques related to a transformation, that is translation, rotation, scaling, reflection and shear. Now in this session we will see the rotations of a transformation, how the rotation will be working on related to a 2D. Now we will discuss that. So in a computer graphics, 2D rotation is the process of rotating an object with respect to an angle in a two-dimensional plane. So that's why it is called as a rotation. So a two-dimensional rotation is applied to an object by repositioning it along a particular path with an XY plane. So to generate a rotation, we can specify the rotation angle theta, the position of the rotation point about which object is to be rotated. So suppose in the diagram, consider a point O that is has to be rotated from an angle to another and in a 2D plane, that is known as a rotation. So let's see in this diagram, it is representations of 2D rotation. So we have your object that is O. After rotating from one angle to theta in a 2D plane, it will goes on new generating rotation point, that is O0. So see, the initial coordinate of an object O will be X old and Y old. So initial angle of an object O with respect to a by the rotation angle will be a theta. So whatever the new coordinates of an object after the rotation, that is X new and Y new of a O dash point object. So by how it can be achieved by using the following rotation equation. So that is X new equal to your X old coordinate into cos of theta minus Y old into sine of theta. This is for the X new generation coordinate. And related to Y new generation coordinate, we required X old into of your sine theta plus Y old into of cos theta. So this is the rotation equation for generating new coordinate of an object, that is X new and Y new. So the, in a matrix form, the rotation equation may be represented as by shown in figure, that is X new Y new equal to cos theta minus sine theta cos theta into X old and Y old, where theta is in your rotations angle of your after rotations we get a new coordinate. So this is how the working of your rotations in a 2D plane. So we will take one more example to so this is an homogeneous coordinate representations of a rotation matrix in a 3x3 matrix. So this is X new, Y new and 1 equal to cos theta minus sine theta 0, sine theta cos theta 0, 0, 0, 1 into your X old, Y old and 1. So this is the homogeneous representations of a 3x3 matrix after rotating. So on this, we will take one example or problem statement to solve the rotation matrix. So example will be like, given a line segment with starting points are 0, 0, ending point is 4, 4 and your rotation's angle will be a 30 degree anti-clockwise direction. In the line segment, we have to finding out the new coordinate after the rotation. So now we will solve this. So we have your old ending coordinate, that is X old, Y old will be a 0, 4 and 4. Rotation angle will be a 30. So applying a new coordinate, the line of after rotation will be X new and Y new. So apply the equations, we can get X new equal to, we have a equation X old into cos theta minus of Y old into sine theta. put the values related to x volt, cos theta and sin theta. So we can get x nu will be 1.46. Same for finding out the new coordinate after related to y. So equation will be x volt into a sin theta plus y volt into a cos theta. So putting the values of x and y and theta in a equation, so we can get the answer will be a 5.46. So this is the new coordinate after the rotation, that is 1.46 and 5.46. So we can get the result after the rotations. So this is how the calculation will be work whenever we can apply the rotations on your 2D plane. And this is the matrix calculation related to your rotation. So we will put the values on a matrix form, that is x nu and y nu equal to cos theta minus sin theta cos theta into x old and y old. So put the values related to equation, that is x nu equal to cos 30 minus 30 sin 30 cos 30 into 4 into 4. So where cos 30 is an 3 by root 3 by 2, and sin 30 will be 1 by 2. So we can get after the matrix multiplications of these two matrices, we can get the values of x nu and y nu, that is 1.46 and 5.46 after the rotations in a 2D transformation. So this is how the examples of solving the rotations by using an rotations angle in a 2D transformation. So this is how it will be worked. So thank you, and we will stop here.